cite local resources.
We had the transvaginal ultrasound bill before seven other states did. If you let it happen in Texas, it will come to your state.
Right. But what about your state changing? That's my question. Is it a foregone conclusion that these people are going to take over and rule forever? I mean, at some point or other, most reasonable people will realize that this is not representative of the average folk. This is fanaticism combined with greed.
It is, and I want to be careful not to be caught up in a red.
Ian Masters, he is so prejudiced and biased against conservatives. Now he's talking about Texas and their... And Rick Perry leading the way against abortion, or trying to restrict abortion, especially abortion that's going to be not only dangerous, not only deadly to the baby, but also dangerous for the woman.
Female politicians, and that the Democratic Party needs to open up its gatekeepers and who controls candidate selection process a lot better. We certainly need better pressure recruiting. And Wendy Davis, as a self-made woman, a single mother who put herself through school and got to Harvard Law, I'll agree with you on that. She's a great woman, okay? But one person can't save the party. And the governor's, you know, position in Texas isn't actually that strong. Her as governor would not be our saving grace. We need a lot more people at district levels, local levels, precinct levels, to be able to get into the process to make the executive position in Texas worth anything.
Well, that's the peculiar part of Texas politics, right? The governor is somewhat symbolic, even though you've had the former governor become president of the United States.
Absolutely. It's very scary. He did that with the help of his father, though. So.
Yeah, right. But it certainly didn't hurt him to have that on his resume. Mm-hmm. So the real power, is it the lieutenant governor, Dewhurst?
That's why there's this, you know, a lot of this has been an intense...
But what about real Christians? I mean, genuine Christians. As far as I know, Jesus Christ did not carry an assault rifle. He did not shake down poor people for money on television. He didn't.
There's no abortion passage in the Bible. They didn't refer
exactly,
about
exactly. So at what point can you mobilize real Christians against these kind of jihadi Christians?
Well, I think one point is to recognize the Christians who were trying, and that would be Texas for Choice. They have been showing up consistently in these debates and offering another position to these politicians.
These two are so anti-faith, wingnut liberals. Ian Masters, he comes on the air here on KPFK here in Los Angeles.
Religious community. I have to stand up as a person of faith and a civic individual.
She says she's a person of faith.